Welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the Saturday study talks. I'm sorry because since last two Saturdays, I have been not uploading any video related to Saturday study talks. It's because of my ill health. I was unable to read the comments nor reply to you guys. So I thought, let me collect all those questions and select few questions and answer in this week. So here we go. And I'm so sorry because there are 500 questions. I have selected only 10 questions because most of the questions are repetitive and I can't answer each and every question. So I'm sorry. So now let's begin the video. Coming to the first question, now let's see the education related questions. First question is from Malar ES. Okay, hello Malar ES. Hi. This question is about TS ISET. If there is a gap between graduation to MBA, is it required to produce gap certificate at counseling? Please reply, ma'am. Okay. So, hi Malar. Coming to the gap certificate, you must have gap certificate while counseling because as you have a gap in your education, they will ask you to submit the gap certificate. Now, I'm going to clarify your doubts regarding gap certificate. What is the gap certificate means? If students like you have a gap in their education or if they take gap to give the entrance exam for next course, then you need to produce the gap certificate. And coming to the gap certificate format, there is no prescribed format. You have to go to your college. Every college will have its own gap certificate format. So how to make gap certificate is that first you have to meet a lawyer and then you want to tell you the like you have to clarify the reason of your gap certificate, and your gap certificate will be prepared by the lawyer. And usually he takes some 100 or 200 rupees and issues the gap certificate for you. So now let's see the next question. Next question is from M. Uma Devi. Hi Uma Devi. Ma'am, I got 596 marks. 596 rank, BC D category. Can I get a seat in Kakatiya University at Warangal for TS LOSSET? Okay, so congratulations Uma Devi, because 596 is really good rank. First of all, congratulations, and 100% you're going to get seat at Kakadiya College because you have reservation also and you have good rank also. So you are going to get rank for sure. Sorry, you're going to get admission for sure at Kakadiya College. And you can also get like for this particular rank, you can also get seat in few more colleges such as Aurora, Mahatma Gandhi Law College, and you know Adarsha College, and few more other colleges as well, because you got really good rank. Congratulations once again. So now let's see the next question. Next question is from Find Out. Okay, hi Find Out, nice name. Please tell the cutoff for electronic science of UGC NET. I got 48% and I am SC category. Okay, nice question. So now let's see the cutoff for general category. If you are a general category candidate, if you have no reservation, then the cutoff will be 40%. Like in paper 1, you have to get 40%, and as well as in paper 2, you have to get 40%. As you have reservation, if it is SC, ST, OBC or PWD, you must get at least 35% in paper 1 and 35% in paper 2 as well. So I hope I answered your question. So now let's see next question. It's from Sandeep Chasia. Okay, hi Sandeep. What about Sorry, I'm unable to read your question. It's coming. Yeah, what about forensic science subject cutoff in UGC NET? Okay, I'm going to answer your question now. See, subject-wise cutoff will be different and category-wise cutoff will be different. Now I am going to answer you subject-wise cutoff for UGC NET as well as category-wise cutoff as well. If you, for example, okay, I'm giving subject-wise as well as category-wise, listen carefully. Coming to economics, if you are unreserved candidate and if you are for JRF and Assistant Professor 2019, then your cutoff will be 75% if you are unreserved category, if you have no reservation. And coming to only Assistant Professor, the cutoff is 65%. So if you are SC or ST, for economics, your cutoff is 63%. If it is for JRF and Assistant Professor, if it is only for Assistant Professor, cutoff is just 50%, like 50. And coming to the political science, if you are unreserved category, JRF and Assistant Professor, cutoff is 66. Okay. And coming to the only Assistant Professor, your cutoff is 56%. And if you are reserved category for political science, such as SC and ST, your cutoff will be 55%. For assistant professor as well as JRF. If it is only for assistant professor, your cutoff must be at least 46. Okay, so now let me answer your direct question, which is for forensic science. So coming to the forensic science, it's if you are unreserved category. And if you have applied for JRF as well as assistant professor, the cutoff should be at least 68. And if you are applied, like if you have applied only for assistant professor, your cutoff is 61. And if you have reservation, SC or ST or PWD, PWD is different for SC and ST, forensic science. At least 60 is the cutoff for JRF and assistant professor, and coming to only assistant professor, your cutoff is 52. Okay, and if your PWD 46 is for JRF and assistant, for only assistant professor, it is also 46. So I hope I answered your question, which is a lengthy question. So coming to the next question. It's from Fahim Sheikh. Okay, hi Fahim. I am from BCE category. I got 392 marks in 2019 NEET. Is there any chance of getting a medical seat in AP? Actually, you have reservation, so you have 80% of chance of getting the medical seat in AP. Congratulations, Fahim. So coming to the next question is from Padmalakshmi. Hi Padmalakshmi. Ma'am, this is for AP student weightage or will Telangana MCET AP student weightage? Okay. Coming to your question, I understood your question as is AP student for Telangana has high weightage sorry, if AP, okay. Okay, I understood your question. Will AP students have? Okay, I understood you. Okay, I understood. Okay, Padmalakshmi, I understood your question. Okay, cut. Okay, now let's see next question. Next question is from Padmalakshmi. Hi, Padmalakshmi. Ma'am, will AP MCET have high weightage or Telangana MCET have high weightage? Actually, both NSETs, like statewide, so both has equal weightage. It's nothing like AP has high weightage or Telangana has high weightage. Both NSET marks will have high weightage and equal priority. So coming to the next question is from M. Manamma. Okay, hi Manamma. Please give details about online payment process fee for APISET. Okay. So coming to the APISET payment procedure, if you are OC category, general category or BC, you have to pay 1200 rupees through online. Okay. And if you are SC or ST, your fee is 600 rupees through online. So you can pay either through credit card, debit card, or even through net banking. So how to pay is that first you have to go to the official website. There you have to click on ISET fee payment online. After clicking on that link, they'll ask you to enter your AP ISET hall ticket number. So you have to also enter your rank. Based upon that, after entering all the required details which they ask you, you have to click on submit. After clicking on submit, they'll ask you to pay online. Okay, then you have to pay your fees, like ISET fees online. So then you have to enter all your credentials regarding online payment, and based upon your reservation or category, you'll be asked to pay a particular fee. You have to pay the particular fee, and after successful payment, you have to take the print or the screenshot of the successful fee payment. Okay, because that form will be like the evidence that you have paid your fee. Okay, so coming to the next question is from Daya. Hi Daya, ma'am, fee structure for MBA in CBIT is how much? I got 5600 rank in TS ISET. Which university and which college is better for me? Please reply, ma'am. Okay, hi Daya. First of all, congratulations on getting 5600 rank. It's a good rank. Coming to the fee structure in MBA in CBIT is it'll be approx 30,000, and year by year or within 2 to 3 years, fee will be changing. So just to visit the website of the official website of CBIT and keep referring to the fees so that you'll have the current knowledge about the fee, and it will not be more than 35,000 for sure. And as you got 5,600 rank, you can happily go to the MBA college for CBIT because it accepts this rank. Like CBIT accepts this 5,600 rank. And coming to the universities, OU is fine. It's best. And colleges, most of the colleges does not object your rank, because 90% of the colleges which offer MBA will accept this rank because this is good rank. Congratulations. So next question is from Srikar Chikkudu. Okay, hi Srikar. Ma'am, I am from BSc MPC Chemistry. I'm in confusion about my future. Which is better, ma'am? Whether it is MBA or MCA, please suggest, ma'am. Okay, so you're from BSc. So if you are interested in software profession, DBA profession, like if you wanted to be a database analyst, like database related jobs, or if you are interested in the languages such as C, C++, Java.NET and all, or if you would like to be a web developer or anything related to the software, go for MCA. If you wanted to be management side or marketing side, sales side, production, like some job which is related to the MBA, then take MBA. It's simple. Okay, first of all, decide what you want to be in future, then you can happily decide whether you wanted to go to MBA or MCA. All the very best. So coming to the next question is from Adi Narayan Reddy Kumata. Okay, hi Adi Narayan Reddy. Ma'am, I want to MCA colleges list, please, ma'am. Okay, I think you wanted me to tell you the MCA colleges list here. And the question is still there. First of all, let me answer you this part of your question. So, coming to the colleges which accept TSICET for MCA is Osmania University. Osmania OU will accept ICET as well as MCA. It's an MCA offering university, and few more other are CBIT, Chaitanya Bharati Institute of Technology, offers MCA and accepts TSICET rank, and Saint Joseph's Degree and PG College Hyderabad accepts TSICET as well as MCA as well, and few more colleges are Saint Anne's College for Women and Vasavi College, and SSJ Engineering College. So these are the few colleges which accept TSICET rank, as well as they also offer you MCA. So coming to the second part of your question, ma'am, I got like the same person, ma'am, I got 23,000 rank. So can I get a seat or not? Okay, 23,000 rank. You cannot get through the convener quota. You have to try getting through management quota. You can get in most of the colleges with this rank, no problem, because very few people, like, only like in TSICET, only 30 to 35% of the students will go for MCA. So you can happily get the seat. You need not worry, and all the best. So coming to the next question is from Kiran Janu. Okay, hi Kiran. Hi madam, I had completed commerce in inter. I am interested in software. I wanted to do degree in which is the best course, ma'am? Okay, okay, Kiran, you have completed your commerce in inter, and if you are interested in software, then I would like to suggest you to go to BSc, because it is also having the subjects which are related to software, or BCA. BCA is best for software. Okay, if you are like completely interested to be in software in future, go for BCA. Okay, or BSc, anything is fine. So all the best. Coming to the next question is from Saiteja Birwali. Hi Saiteja. Ma'am, I got 62 marks. Where can I get seat in TSICET? Okay, 62 marks is really good score. But you didn't mention whether you wanted to get through MBA or MCA. If it is for MBA, you'll be having high competition for these marks. If you are MCA, I think you can get in most of the colleges through management quota. All the best. So coming to the next question is from Naga Peddi Raju. Okay, hi Naga Peddi Raju. Ma'am, please provide me AP ICET rank-wise colleges list. Sure. So AP ICET 2019 college-wise list, the cutoff list of college-wise, I'm going to tell you now. Coming to the JNTU marks, rank is you should have rank at least from 1 to 12. Okay, if your rank is between these, you can happily go to the JNTU. And coming to the like this JNTU is which is in Kakinada, because this is AP ICET college-wise list. So this is Kakinada JNTU University. Okay, so coming to Sri Venkateswara University, which is in Tirupati, you should get rank at least below 80. Okay, if your rank is at least below 80 for APISET, this particular college will accept your admission. And few more colleges is Andhra University, which is in Visakhapatnam. You should get at least 220 rank, below 220 rank in APISET to get into this particular university. And coming to the राजीव गांधी मेमोरियल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी नंदियाल विच इज इन कर्नूल. यू शुड गेट एटलीस्ट 10,000 रैंक टू गेट एडमिटेड इन टू दिस कॉलेज. सो आई होप यू आई आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन. सो नाउ लेट्स सी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन एंड द लास्ट एजुकेशन रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम नल्ला असवानी. हाई नल्ला असवानी, प्लीज सेंड मी प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस ऑफ यूपीएससी मेन्स वन. ओके, आई थिंक यू कैन गेट दैट थ्रू ऑनलाइन ऑल्सो. सो श्योर, नो प्रॉब्लम, आई विल मेक अ वीडियो रिगार्डिंग यूपीएससी मेन्स. सो स्टे ट्यून्ड टू माई चैनल. यू विल बी नोटिफाइड वेन एवर आई मेक योर वीडियो इफ यू आर सब्सक्राइब्ड एंड इफ यू हिट द बेल आइकन. सो वन लास्ट क्वेश्चन विच इज पर्सनल क्वेश्चन. आई हैव सेलेक्टेड ओनली वन पर्सनल क्वेश्चन. द पर्सनल क्वेश्चन इज मैम, विच गेम इज योर फेवरेट ऑनलाइन गेम. ओके, सो कमिंग टू द ऑनलाइन फेवरेट गेम्स, आई वुड लाइक टू एंड लव टू प्ले लूडो किंग एंड आई प्ले कैंडी क्रश एज वेल. आई यूज टू प्ले कैंडी क्रश एंड फ्यू मोर अदर गेम्स विच आर माई फेवरेट आर आई प्ले द पैटर्न गेम्स लाइक यू नो यू लाइक मेमोरी बेस्ड गेम्स. लाइक यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट पैटर्न एंड दे विल गिव यू 30 सेकेंड्स. यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट पैटर्न. आफ्टर 30 सेकेंड्स द होल पैटर्न विल बी वैनिश एंड यू हैव टू एडजस्ट द सेम पैटर्न. यू हैव टू मेक द सेम पैटर्न. सो द लेवल विल बी इंक्रीजिंग लाइक एज द टाइम पासिस द लेवल विल बी इंक्रीजिंग. द डिफिकल्टी ऑल्सो विल बी इंक्रीजिंग. सो इट्स वेरी गुड गेम विच इम्प्रूव योर कॉन्सेंट्रेशन एंड ऑल. सो दैट्स इट विद द पर्सनल क्वेश्चन एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट नोटिस एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग विच आई वॉन्टेड टू टेल यू इन दिस वीडियो एंड ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर मैसेजिंग मी टू सजेस्ट वॉट इज द बेस्ट सी आर टी ऑनलाइन ट्रेनिंग सेंटर. सो देर इज दिस वन वेबसाइट विच इज कॉल्ड सेट योर रैंक डॉट कॉम. देर देल प्रोवाइड यू AWS कोर्स, जावा कोर्स, स्पोकन इंग्लिश एंड सी आर टी एंड ऑल कोर्सेस थ्रू ऑनलाइन विच इज द बेस्ट थिंग फ्रॉम एनी पार्ट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. यू कैन हैप्पीली रजिस्टर एंड द ग्रेटेस्ट थिंग इज दैट they also provide you crash courses. If you have no time to take the long term courses, you can happily go to the crash course also. And any course is just for 999 rupees, which is the least and the best cost. So register at setyourrank.com. The link is in the description below. And you can also mail me if you are interested to register through that course. If you're not like you know, if you're confused about the courses or if you're confused about any other things, you can feel free to mail me. My mail address is bestwaytostudy7@gmail.com. And if you are interested to buy merchandise, that is best way to study t-shirts, you can happily go to the my mail which is in the description below and you can happily drop a mail. The prices are very cheap compared to any other things. It's just for 499 rupees. It's in sale now, so if you're interested you can feel free to go there and happily check out the merchandise and you can happily drop me a mail if you're interested to buy the t-shirt of Best Way to Study. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon for more such videos. Like and share this video. And every Saturday, I'll be answering your questions in Saturday Study Talks. So if you have any questions related to your career or education related questions, job related questions, or if you want me to answer your personal questions, you can happily comment in the comment section below. I'll be answering every Saturday. Thanks for watching. All the very best for your future and subscribe.